Hey there, everyone. Meteorologist Jim Dickey here in the Stormwarn 7 Hurricane Center with the latest edition of Tracking the Tropics here on this Monday, September the 25th. We still have two active storms out there in the Atlantic, in Maria and Lee, but especially Maria looking far less healthy than it did even this time yesterday. I also want to point out, just speaking to the fact that every tropical system is different, take a look at the difference in size between Maria and Lee. We're talking Maria's cloud field somewhere over 600 miles, and then Lee barely over 100. In fact, you can basically take Lee and put it over the center of Maria. It's just incredible the difference in size between those two storms, both of which look to be weakening, neither of which look to bring direct impacts to land, at least no landfalls. Maria going to get pretty close to the Outer Banks here as we go through the next 24, 48 hours. But as I'll show you, going to get kicked out to sea before it does. Let's actually take a look at the GO satellite imagery on Maria. And it has really weakened. You're looking at IR satellite, so you're looking at more or less the temperature of cloud tops. And if you think back to what this looked like, going back to when this was over Puerto Rico, we had sort of this here. These are your higher clouds, where you would expect to see the heavier the rainfall. But in general, I think that's mainly cirrus clouds up in the atmosphere. But usually with a healthy hurricane, you have those very bright colors showing up right around the center, right around in that area. That's exactly what Maria looked like as it was making landfall in Puerto Rico. And really, even 48 hours ago, it had that very well-defined center of heavy thunderstorms right around the eye, that very pronounced eye wall. That has completely fallen apart as it moved northward here. Now, as you see it swirling, you can barely make out the eye on this. A little bit of a blow-up of thunderstorm activity right there, just in the past couple of minutes, near the eye. So, yeah, it's still a hurricane. It still has that warm core tropical center, but it's no longer what it once was. And there's a couple reasons for this. It is moving into cooler waters. See the water temperatures right now. Whereas when we're talking about the Caribbean, we had all those numbers in the middle 80s. We're moving more towards that threshold. Usually we talk about 78 degrees is the bottom, the floor of how cool it can be for tropical storms to maintain themselves. But even when you're talking about 80 degrees, 81, you can still maintain a hurricane. You're not going to see it explode and develop like that. But I think more to the point, Maria is going over the same waters that were just traversed by Jose. And as you look over the ocean heat content, this is pretty zoomed out, but Maria is just off to the east of Georgia and South Carolina. Notice that deep blue shade. Basically, Jose used up nearly all of that ocean heat content from the Gulf Stream as it churned its way northward very slowly. So there's not much left for Maria to work with. And really, it was like clockwork. As soon as it moved north of the 30-degree north latitude, it really fell apart pretty quickly. And we'll get back to this graphic in a second because you'll notice that sort of bullseye of red in the Western Caribbean. That will be something to watch as we go into October. But again, here is the latest on Maria. Still a hurricane, but barely. We're a weak Category 1 now. Winds 80 miles per hour. It's moving to the due north at 7 miles per hour. Their tropical storm warnings out for the Outer Banks of North Carolina. It's going to get very close to the Outer Banks and likely produce those winds, 40, 45 miles per hour. Going to act sort of like a bad nor'easter in these areas, meaning we'll see some minor flooding at high tide with those onshore winds. Could see some outer bands of rain working in. But other than that, and the periodically gusty winds up towards 40 miles per hour, not going to be much of an impact there as it gets close, but then the jet stream sweeps in, gives it a firm kick out to the north and east. By Friday, it's well on its way out to sea. By Saturday, it's off the coast of Newfoundland. Actually, the remnants could make its way all the way towards Iceland in the UK. Won't be tropical by then. But could be a gusty rain for our friends over there, which actually sets us up for a bit of a break as we go through the last couple days of September. As we start off October, there's no imminent systems looking to develop here anytime soon. We've sort of shut down the coast of Africa now. Cape Verde season coming to an end as of the ocean heat content out there has really shut down. And as we head into October, it's sort of like going back to July or June, where we look for development closer to home. A bit different, though, because we still have the summertime heat build up in the Western Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico. So This is when you look over all the hurricanes that have formed over the years through October and the tracks they've taken. This is what climatology tells us to look for. And of course, you'll notice that that sort of common track takes the storm out of the Western Caribbean up through South Florida. So that's something we're going to watch for. And in fact, the models are sort of hinting at that. And it's no surprise as to why. Because again, as we go back over to that ocean heat content graphic, look at that bullseye of red setting up in the Western Caribbean. Whereas various hurricanes we've seen throughout this season have helped to cut out some of that heat content in the Southwest Atlantic, from Irma, Maria, and Jose. You see south of Puerto Rico, Maria helped to sort of eat that up. In the Western Gulf, there's still some ocean heat content out there, but Harvey helped to take some of that away. In fact, you even look close to the coast here near the Gulf of Mexico, and you see that blue working in off of our western coast. Irma helped to churn up some of that. But in particular, the Western Caribbean has been more or less untouched since Franklin came through well over a month ago. So with that in mind, that's an area we're going to watch. And the GFS model has been sort of keying in on this area. Something I want to talk about is the Central American gyre. So what that means is what's going to set up here, and we had this once before this season, I believe it was back in June, you get strong westerly winds setting up south of Central America, and then you have your trade winds strengthening across the Caribbean. That gives you a very broad counterclockwise circulation, which is very broad cyclonic flow or broad low pressure. And when we sort of have this setting up, you can sometimes see tropical systems spin up. You can also see models getting very confused by it and popping out tropical cyclones that never really materialize. So as we go forward in the model, I think it's important to note that this might not necessarily come to fruition, but we have the heat content there. We have broad low pressure there. So definitely as we go into October, this will be the spot in the world to watch, at least in the Atlantic, to watch for potential development. You see here, this is going into next Monday. And you see there's a tropical cyclone spinning up on this model off the southern coast of Mexico. Advance this even further, and this is as we get all the way a week plus out from now. We're talking two Thursdays from now. And you'll see it's trying to spin up something right over Central America. Again, the point being, this is the area you're going to have to keep an eye on as we go into the first and second week of October. Hurricane season by no means over and done with just yet. You know, hurricane season goes all the way through the end of November. So some takeaways here. Maria falling apart. There's going to be some gusty winds, some beach erosion, minor coastal flooding during high tide for the Outer Banks in North Carolina. Outside of that, Maria heads out as we close out the week over and done with. And once Maria and Lee fizzle out, there's no areas we're watching right now for potential development. At least through the next 5 days, it looks like we do get a bit of a break here. Might even be a brief period where we have no-name storms out there in the Atlantic. That would be nice, to say the least. But we're not done with hurricane season just yet, and as we head into October, one area in particular we're going to keep a close eye on, the Western Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico. Still plenty of ocean heat content there, and climatology tells us this is where we need to watch, and there's no reason to think we couldn't get something to spin up there as we go through those first 2 weeks of October. But nothing there just yet, so be sure to continue to check in with this here. Of course, we'll be keeping a close eye on these areas here at ABC 7, but for now, enjoy the break. I'm meteorologist Jim Dickey. Have a good afternoon.